As a DevOps engineer, my responsibility is to build infrastructure and maintain applications that provide a high level of reliability and resilience for my organization. Partnering with the GIS team, I've provisioned a Kubernetes cluster and deployed ArcGIS Enterprise on Kubernetes for production use. Now, as everyone knows, the best place to test is in production. So today, we're going to execute a chaos test in which we simulate the loss of an availability zone and observe the impact on our organization. An availability zone, or AZ, is roughly analogous to a data center with multiple AZs within any given region. In order to prepare for this level of outage, we've taken advantage of two features in the ArcGIS Enterprise on Kubernetes product, the Cloud Native Object Store and the multi-AZ deployment method. First, when we configure an organization to use the Cloud Object Store, we can take advantage of the resiliency offered by the cloud provider's service. And we also reduce the in-cluster workloads by removing those associated stateful sets. Second, when we deploy using the multi-AZ method, we must set a new availability topology key. This key allows us to define a new separation boundary as each AZ, as depicted by the blue, yellow, and green bars. When deploying using the enhanced availability architecture profile and updated key, the software enforces topology spread constraints. This ensures separation at the time of creation and makes sure that we have an even spread of our volume-dependent workloads across our AZs. Now, we can see that there's been disruption in the cluster as these machines were terminated, and a number of pods have shifted from a running to a pending state. Next, let's look more closely into how we can assess the operational impacts of such an outage. And for that, I'll hand it over to Bill.
Thank you, Chris. As a chaos coordinator, as a chaos coordinator, I need to quickly assess the impacts of this zone outage. And let's just say Chris has definitely caused us some chaos right now. We can see that a number of pods are in a pending state as Kubernetes is trying to rebalance after its decrease in capacity. Most pods will be successfully rescheduled, but some will not due to their dependency on a zone-specific disk. Let's investigate if our deployment architecture profile is providing the resiliency we anticipate. First, in Enterprise Manager, we don't see any severe logs, so that's great news. Next, a report has just been generated that includes our basic health checks of our core framework services. We see here that the relational data store health check has failed. Let's look at this a little bit more. In validating our relational store, it is now reporting a warning. This means that our primary is healthy, but our standby is not due to it residing in the affected zone. While we are not highly available in this area at the moment, we are still operational. While such a system is resilient, there's no substitute for active monitoring. Using standard tools such as Grafana and JMeter, this dashboard is helping me monitor my critical feature services. This top chart represents successful REST API requests to those services over time. This bottom chart represents any request failures. Now, during this zone outage, it's obvious that there was chaos and it was affecting throughput. However, the most compelling observation is that all of my services continue to respond and will return to their expected performance. As DevOps engineers, we can sleep well, knowing that ArcGIS is resilient, reliable, and observable. And our production geospatial workflows will remain operational, even during the most critical, chaotic of failures. Jay, back to you.